Hey everybody, it's me, Liz, coming to you live from Mom's Kitchen. It's Wednesday, hello. I've just made a video of me getting my roasting chicken ready and putting my roasting chicken in the oven. And it's got to cook for 5 hours at 250 degrees. Yes, it is an adaptation of Beth Cooking and Crafting's Mom's Sticky Chicken. But I'm not really sharing all kinds of credit or what's sharing. I'm not riding her coattails because I changed all the spicing and did it differently. But I'm still cooking it for 5 hours at 250, and that's what she did, and I like that idea. So that's what I'm doing. So in 5 hours, I'll have another video, but for right now, it's sweet treat time in the afternoon, and I'm making I promised that I would make something with this leftover dough. Obviously, I'm going to fry it. Fried dough is yummy. I'm going to make, as you know by the title now, fried ice cream calzone. And before I do that, though, because ice cream is very tricky and I have to move very quickly, in fact, I'm going to heat my oil right now while we're talking. I am going to and get a plate ready to put it on and eat it and show you it. What I said in my chicken video, I'm saying in this video too and in subsequent videos, because not everybody watches all of my videos. I've made a Facebook page and I've made it a business page because, and you can watch the chicken video now for the longer explanation. I'll just give you the shorter explanation. I made it a business page because Facebook makes you do that now because you're not allowed to open a personal page without your real name or a name that sounds like a real name. I couldn't do House of Snarzel or Liz House of Snarzel. I had to do it. A friend of mine got banned and had to be blah, blah, blah. It's a long story. Listen, watch the chicken video later. But I've made a Facebook page, and it's got pictures. It's got pictures. There's a picture of me on there for those curious about what I look like who don't know what I look like. Because for years on YouTube, I used to vlog, and a lot of people know what I look like. But not everybody knows what I look like, so there's a picture of that on my page. Anyway, go like my page. And then when you like my page on Facebook, then you'll see me put up pictures of things that I make that I don't make videos of. Things I do that I don't put on videos on YouTube that I do. You can talk to me. You can post your pictures on my page of your food and your yummy things that you make. Do it. It's going to be in the vid description, as it was yesterday in my Cheetos calzone video, but some people don't read the vid description. You really should read the vid description, you know, because sometimes I say funny things, and sometimes I give important information. Sometimes I even say hello to you personally. How do you know? Read it. Okay. What's a calzone have on it? Tomato sauce, just like pizza. You saw the colored sprinkles on the outside. I thought it would taste good to make it taste Mexican-y, like the Mexicans make, where they put cinnamon sugar on their fried ice cream ball things. I don't think anybody really fries ice cream in regular pizza dough. I mean, I'm sure it's been done a million times and there are places people do it, but it's not the traditional way to fry ice cream. I don't have many other toppings in the house. I thought about putting cereal on there to be cute, more Captain Crunch, or some more of those crunched up graham crackers. But then I thought about the other times I've done that recently where my wet ingredients make those ingredients soggy. So I'm going to keep it simple, stupid, and just do it with chocolate sauce and ice cream. The ice cream is Friendly's brand Cape Cod fudge or something. It's got like shell chocolate in it, chocolate syrup in it, little chunks of chocolate. It's amazing. I've already got it ready to throw in very quickly. It's nice and frozen in sort of the shape I wanted it in. No, it's not. It's starting to melt. It's another warm day here in CT, here in the CT. Okay, licking my fingers. Shouldn't be licking my fingers. Washing my hand. Here I go. Sure, I'm scared. Aren't you scared? I'd be scared. In fact, if I was smarter, I would put it, that chocolate sauce is going to be a breach, you know. It's totally going to be a breach. So what am I going to do? If I was smart, I would put this back in the freezer right now and then freeze it in like 10 minutes when it firms back up again. But you know what I decided? I decided that if this doesn't turn out and it melts, like I cut into it and it just goes whoosh, I'm going to call it deep fried milkshake. any port in a storm, any solution to any problem, you just ask me, Liz, House of Snarzel. Okay, ready? Oh, you gotta see this, don't you? Kind of defeats the purpose if you can't see it. Shit, I gotta move the camera. Sorry, I swore. Be right back. Well, you're coming with me. Here we go. Holy crumoly. I don't know if I can do this. Can you see that? Alright. I better get the flour ready for the big fire. What happens when the ice cream leaks in there? Shit. Stand back, everybody. I just forgot about the ice cream part. What happens when the ice, when there's a breach and the ice cream gets in the oil? Ah, I'm scared! Oh my god. Pot lid. Ready with a pot lid, everyone. Ready with a pot lid. Okay. This has drama, doesn't it? It's full of drama. Okay. My oil's not too hot, which is good. Everything's coming along gently. Look how pretty. You know me and the colored sprinkles. I can't take it. I love them so much. I wish I had a kitchen like I told this to Tammy Yo-Yo Max the other day in her comment section. I so wish that I had her whole kitchen full of those Wilton candy melts and all of her decorations that she's got. One of these days, I'm going to get back on my financial feet and go out and buy all that stuff. I must have it. Okay. I hear a breach. Do you hear a breach? Kinda. Let's turn it again. Oh, people, and it smells like cinnamon. What do you think? I think breach now, maybe? The question is it cooked? I don't know. I have it on so low, I worry that the dough isn't cooked. Should I brave it? It feels crunchy. I am crazy. Ready? Here we go. Okay, there was a breach, but it looks just like only chocolate sauce got in. Alright. Back. Well, here we are, back with the beautiful finished melting out the side calzone thing. There's ice cream coming out of there for sure. Let's have a little cut into it, eh? I'm going to cut straight down the middle. I don't think we're going to have any food porn of this. So the question is, how melted is the ice cream? Well, see it? Let's see how cold it is. That'll be a judge. Well, of course, that's a whole piece of ice cream. Mmm. Ooh, and a piece of that fudge. What do you guys think? Should I call it ice cream calzone, or should I call it milkshake calzone? I call it incredibly delicious and cold on my teeth. And I wish that my mom wasn't out watering her flowers in here to enjoy it before it melts completely. I don't know. I'm gonna call it milkshake calzone. It's damn good, and I'm gonna go eat the part that's still frozen. I'm gonna eat a bunch of it. Like my Facebook page and talk to me. See you next time. See you tonight when I post my chicken video.